For this data science chalk talk, I'd like to talk about pipes in R. Now, by far, the most popular and important pipe in R is the Magruder pipe, which lets one write things like 5 pipe sin as a synonym for sin of 5. So it looks a lot like the mathematical function composition operator. Now, there are some details of this, and some syntactic details of this. Now, this is a syntactic sugar, so syntactic details are actually very important. Is, how do we write the function sin? Is it written as its name, which can pull up its value? Is it written as this sort of elided form, or is it written with a placeholder, or is it written with a different, larger placeholder? Now, this one is not possible at the package level due to the fact that most R identifiers are not allowed to start with an underbar. So without some hacking, you probably can't do this one without some language cooperation, which is what the base R language pipe is going to do, I believe. It's going to use that as a possible placeholder, though it'll probably also allow these forms. We see pipes in functional languages a lot. And I think the reason we see them is functional languages don't often have good object notation. Now, you can always play the games that objects are poor man's closures, closures are poor man's objects. But basically, there are some nice things about objects. For instance, my favorite example is scikit-learn's pipeline operator, which coordinates how very different methods fit, transform, work together. So it basically documents how these methods work together during composition. The interesting thing about the pipe is, of course, the semantics. What do you want it to mean? Now, Magruder has fairly complicated emergent semantics, though obviously Magruder's got a new version. The proposed language inclusion to R sounds like it's going to be at the syntactic level, so that the composition, really, you can write this, and it's as if you wrote this in terms of order of operation, exception handling, stack traces. So that's an interesting one. I actually think this is going the wrong direction, but that's where it's going to go. I think, basically, there's two points being very much missed in any discussion of pipes in R. The first is the one I was alluding to, is that basically, pipes are sort of the poor man's method allocator. So basically what we mean by that is A piped into B in a functional language or that had objects, which R does. R has many object systems, the most important one being S3. But basically this is shorthand for A.F of B, where F is some canonical function name nobody needs to know about, or in S3 notation, f of a, b. Because in S3, what f you've gotten depends on the class, the runtime class of this object, which in an object-oriented system we would write like this. So in this formulation, if you're trying to use the pipe to get the power of method dispatch into your functional language, then you know that a is a value. Otherwise, you can't see its class. So the delayed evaluation that's inherent in this syntactic transform doesn't actually work for you. I've got an article on the pipes in the R journals, where I discuss in detail some semantic possibilities. The second point is R already has a pipe in the base language, in addition to Magruder. This glyph functions like a pipe as long as you insist on this notation of a placeholder. And you just, by glyph, I mean read these four characters as if they were one symbol. Obviously, in actuality, they are a write assignment, the name of a variable, and a statement end. And that is the other notion of composition. Once you get into more advanced mathematics like category theory, you realize that function composition is not the only example of associative composition. And in fact, the generalization is called arrows, and arrows are often described as a programmable semicolon, basically the thing that declares you're done with one statement, ready to execute another with the state of the first statement present. So, in my opinion, the R syntactic proposal is an interesting way to go. I am somewhat interested. I think these three notations are acceptable. I think this one is, in my opinion, everyone has an opinion. I think this is saying that this is not the function, this is the function already called, so I don't particularly like that one. This one, dot, is an actual variable people can use. So if you're going to do it at the syntactic level, it is kind of tempting to get this placeholder that is syntactically unavailable to extension packages. And this one is another interesting one because now, you know, this is a function without an annotation or placeholder. So if you're going to do a syntactic conversion like this, I would say that's interesting. Obviously, people have adapted to the Magruder semantics. The reason that Magruder was so successful was the presence of S3, that essentially F of AB was always meant to be shorthand for dispatch A's methodology onto B, so where F is some function name. Obviously, the pipe has no spot for a function name, but that is why this piping so often made sense, is this first argument was so special in R, it was almost always a value. I also don't really think the lazy evaluation buys you anything. The whole point of a pipeline is you're documenting that essentially what you're saying is that a bunch of transforms are happening on this object in sequence. So I think it's quite fair to insist that this object be a value, that holding it unevaluated like every other parameter in a function call actually makes no sense. And that is, you know, again, an issue with S3, that you can't have the first parameter unevaluated and expect to get the class-based method dispatch. So anyway, thank you very much for your time, and thank you for pipes. And I'd also would like to end with, you know, check out this pipe. As long as you're using this notation, you've always had a pipe in R. And thank you very much.